Yes, just weeks after S Club 7 announced they were reuniting for a 25th anniversary tour, they received the shocking news that their friend and band member, Paul Cattermole, had died from an underlying heart condition.
So, now known as S Club, the band have joined forces with the British Heart Foundation to raise awareness.
So, we are joined by John, Rachel, Bradley, Joe and Tina. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And also with Dr. Charmaine Griffiths, Chief Executive of the British Heart Foundation. Thank you to all of you for joining us. Joe, if I can start with you and just ask, I mean, it was so exciting for so many people that you were getting back together. Mm-hmm. And then just take us through how events panned out.
I think it was just a complete and utter shock, to be honest, because we just had no idea, did we, that Paul did have a heart condition. So obviously, to find out that we'd lost him, it took us quite a long time to process the whole thing. And, it's been a really, really tough few months.
And had you reconnected beforehand? So had you sort of stayed in touch throughout? And sort of what process were you? Had rehearsals started?
Yeah, I mean, we would sort of not always... We've always dipped in and out of each other's lives, haven't we?
Like, we spoke to him on the Monday, didn't we?
We spoke to him on the Monday, yeah. We'd all had, like, a nice Zoom call. And we was just all, like, really upbeat, so excited for the tour, just talking about what we were going to do. So, yeah, literally fast forward
and
a couple of days.
And he was so incredibly excited, wasn't he?
He really was.
So excited, yeah. So, yeah, it's been a really big shock.
And for those people who don't know the timeline there, that was immediately before. That conversation you had was just before you got the news of his death.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Literally days, yeah.
Yeah,
it was the Monday before, and he passed away on the Wednesday.
Yeah, so. And that must have been very shocking for you, that moment.
Yeah, it just a complete and utter shock. We all had a group call. It was around about 9 o'clock, wasn't it, in the evening? And we were just... Yeah, I mean, how do you process that news? It was just... But what was really special is that we had time afterwards to sort of...
We needed time.
Take the time to just chat and share memories and, you know, it was,
Just process the shock of it all.
You'd all known each other, John, for a long time, hadn't you?
I've known Paul since I was 15. Yeah, so it's been a long, long time.
It's sort of akin to a family member, isn't it?
He was absolutely
the closest.
He was a big brother to me. You know, for those years that I was in S Club, I was away from my own family and my own big brothers. So he filled that role for me. It was a huge, massive loss. Massive loss.
And it was so sudden. And what emerged was that he'd had an underlying heart condition.
Yeah.
I mean, you all know him so well. I mean, you obviously so many years have known him, and there was no inkling that this might be an issue.
No. And that's why this campaign is so important, you know, to try and raise awareness about underlying conditions. And Paul was 46, you know, so...
Yeah.
Like there were no signs, were there?
No signs, and I think also you can sort of... Like, you always associate, like, heart and things like to older people. You don't think it's going to happen to people that are so young. And since we lost Paul, we're hearing so many stories of so many young people that are passing away of this. So, you know, for us to be able to jump on board and be a part of this absolutely incredible campaign is so important.
Brad and Tina, we're not forgetting you at the back there. Don't worry, we're not trying to leave
you. You've done a great job.
Okay,
but I dare say you must all have been on a real learning curve about the condition. You know, I'm sure you must have, like everyone does, when someone dies or something you didn't know about, you straight away you start asking questions you've never asked before.
Totally, and that's why we're here today. You know, we just want, if we can help save one life, you know, then we've made a massive difference, you know. So just by raising awareness and being here today, I think we've do a good contribution to this cause. So.
Dutch, do you want to just pick up on some of the details there? Because these guys, obviously, immediately afterwards, would have been asking those questions. Why? How? Why did we know anything in advance? I mean, is it something that happens much? Is it happen often?
Do you know, it happens far too often that families are robbed of a loved one far too early. You know, every 2 hours, someone under 50 dies of heart and circulatory disease, which is why it's so important. And we're so grateful and honoured to be partnering with S Club to raise awareness of these conditions. And our Spotlight On campaign is designed to do just that. It's to shine a light on the fact that heart and circulatory diseases, will affect one in two of us in our lifetimes, and that happens at all ages. And the more we can do to be aware of that and to look after our hearts, the better it will be.
And are there any signs that people can look out for that might give them a warning that potentially they might be one of those one in two people?
Well, look, the most important thing all of us can do to look after our heart health is to do just that, to stay active, to avoid tobacco and to eat a great diet and all of those things, of course. If people do have symptoms and feel uncomfortable, some of the most common symptoms of heart disease can be breathlessness and chest discomfort, and then people should check that out with their GP. Also make sure they go to those regular heart health checks as well. And of course, if someone has more severe symptoms and thinks they're having a heart attack, of course they should seek immediate help and call 999. But honestly, one of the biggest things behind this campaign is we need to fund research to get better at predicting, diagnosing and treating cardiovascular conditions. And that's we do that by investing in brilliant life-saving research, and that's the focus of the campaign and the support that we're getting so brilliantly today.
What do you think of the song?
All great, but I can't dance. We were talking about this earlier. I don't have moves.
You have to move
yeah, you know. Come on.
We do.
Which is it? Yeah. Moves or no moves?
Moves.
Doctor's got moves.
Doctor's got moves.
I think maybe you should come on stage with us.
Yeah.
First Day of Manchester, which is for the British Heart Foundation.
Yeah.
We'll be able to. Hashtag show your heart.
So this feels like an occasion where we need the on-air commitment from the doctor.
We do.
That should be there, you think?
Yeah. I think so. I'll sponsor you. Come on.
Come on. Well, if you do, and you're going to inspire so many millions of people to get behind raising awareness. So if you sponsor and others do, I'm in.
Yeah. Okay, there you go. Yeah. So just explain to people, you've got a single out.
The way we're raising money is on the tour. We have some merchandise that is specifically for the British Heart Foundation, and all the proceeds will go directly to the British Heart Foundation.
I think we can see a little bit of the song that we're talking about these other days. Let's have a look. Because
and Paul very much part of that.
Yes.
Even though he's not going to be on tour with you.
But he will be.
He will be. So tell us about the tour. When does it start?
October the 12th.
12th October, we kick off in Manchester. So we want to see as many people as we possibly can come down. You can still get some tickets. So it'd be really special just to see everyone's faces, get out there on stage and celebrate. Paul's life raise a lot of money for a wonderful charity. British
and after
Foundation.
All this time, is it quite nerve-wracking getting back together and...
Yes?
It's everything, totally.
It aches a lot more.
But whenever we're together, it's like no time's passed at all.
Because the
last time we were all together was 8 years ago, and now we're sort of like, it's like... I don't know,
it's
family.
Like
that's a long time. Who's in charge?
Me.
We had two. Any takers?
I think we're all bosses.
Definitely.
Okay, and I can only imagine, because it's a lovely atmosphere with you here now, but given the circumstances, when you get on tour and you're thinking back, I dare say there are going to be moments, aren't there, where your heads are going to be in different places.
But absolutely.
You will know that in
100%,
advance.
100%, yeah. And I think it's important that we feel all of those things.
Yeah. Mm. And share it with the,
and
with
share
the fans
it with
as
the
well.
Fans
and there's so
well.
Many... I mean, we're so lucky to have so much footage of Paul that we can all share with the fans. And every decision we've made for the tour has had...
Paul's influence.
Paul's been out.
And we're actually asking our fans to send us pictures of showing us your heart. Like
yes, so all the fans
using
we
hashtag
want them.
Show your heart.
Show your heart.
And then we're going to use all those pictures and compile them. And for the first night that we've dedicated to the British Heart Foundation, all your pictures will be up on the screen. You'll actually be part of the tour on the first night as well.
I dare say there may have been times, I don't know individually whether you're all at the same place at the same time. Were there differences in terms of what you felt like you should be doing, getting back together, carrying on?
After we lost Paul?
Yes. Was everyone in the same place?
I think we always knew, didn't we?
There was no question we weren't going to do it. It just changed. Yeah. Obviously, we changed the name of the tour to the Good Times Tour, because that was one of Paul's songs that he was going to do an acoustic version of. So every decision we've made has felt really right in his memory, and it just... there was never a question we weren't going
to
do it.
I think we just needed to just pause for a minute, take a minute and work out the best way that we wanted to do it, and dedicating this show to Paul was the way forward. Because he was so excited. He was so excited for it. So He'd have been very annoyed if we hadn't.
Yeah.
And it's made it a different tour, hasn't it? But in a way, you know, to be able to give that such an important message.
Totally.
That means a lot.
Doctor, the answer to this question is yes. Were you an S Club fan previously?
Ooh. Well, that's always.
You? Always, yeah. It just means such a great deal to us at the British Heart Foundation to have your support. We know it's going to help reach millions of people with important messaging and vital funds for research.
And we know from other campaigns as well, don't we, when guys like these or other people, you know, could be actors, musicians, yep, lend their name to things and share their stories, does make a tangible difference, doesn't it?
Truly does. And we're so grateful. We know that you're going to be reaching millions of people with messaging that will help raise funds to really power that life-saving research and also, as you said, hopefully save lives. So what could be more important?
And just finally, if you could, it's the symbol behind. If you did straight to that camera, camera four, please.
Show your hashtag heart. Show your hearts, please.
Brilliant. And your
you're all very good at getting on the right camera. I always get it wrong.
That was a fluke.
That was a fluke for a while.
We don't usually do that.
That was good. Nice to see you all this morning. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you, Doctor. And the tour starts next month.
Next month.
Yeah.